Fritz?
It's complete. It's finally complete.
What's complete?
Plakta's body.
My body?
Yes. It's my greatest work. A somewhat innocent, yet cool and dignified face. The body of a young woman, complete with beautiful curves and features. And of course, it's both strong and durable. This is it. This really is it. This is my greatest masterpiece.
I see. But this doll really is cute.
Yes. I believe this will suffice as the vessel for Plakta's soul.
Yeah! Thank you so much, Fritz!
No problem. I'll be going now.
It looks like Fritz worked really hard to make your body, Plakta.
It seems so. I can feel an unbelievable amount of detail and dedication in this doll.
Yeah, we'll need to thank Fritz properly later. The doll's body and wind-up springs to move, clothes for her to wear, and the compass of Hades to move her soul. Yeah, it's all ready! Plakta! Everything's all set to turn you into a doll!
You actually did it? To be honest, I'm surprised. It must have been a lot of work to come this far. Thank you very much, Sophie.
No! I couldn't have done all this alone. There was Fritz and Harold, Leon and Corey, Monica, Oscar, and Julio, too. Anyway, lots of people helped me. That's why I was able to come this far.
Still, that doesn't change the fact that you worked very hard. That's why I want to say thank you, Sophie. Thank you for doing all of this for my sake.
Wait, Plakta. It's still too early to say that. You should say it once you've become the doll.
I suppose so.
Okay, then I guess I need to assemble your body first. Let's see. I need to install the wind-up springs into your body. There. Next, I need to put the clothes on. Okay, it's done!
So this is my body.
Yeah, that's right! All that's left is to use the compass of Hades to move your soul.
Yes.
Once I do that, you'll become this doll. Oh, right. I should invite Monica and Oscar. This is a once-in-a-lifetime chance to see your debut!
No. That's not really necessary.
Anyway, I'll be back in a little while!
She really does go out of her way.
I know you came to me before about Plakta's memories, but I never thought you'd do something like this.
I was always kind of thinking this, but you do some crazy things sometimes, Sophie. I know Plakta used to be human, but normal people would never think about turning a book into a doll, you know?
I guess that's true. But this is for Plakta. I'd feel bad if she never got her memories back. I wanted to do everything I could for her. Once I started thinking that way, I couldn't stop.
I don't know if I should call that reckless or not thinking about consequences.
Yeah, but I think that's just part of what makes Sophie Sophie.
Yes, you're right. That's one of her strengths.
Oh, stop it, you two! You're making me blush! Huh? Do I have a visitor this time? Yes, come in!
Hello, Sophie!
Mechlet, Automina! Why are you here?
We felt like you were doing something interesting now. So, we came over.
Looks like we were spot on. Do you mind if we watch too?
Oh, I see. Well, you two have helped me a lot. Okay, I understand. You two can watch too.
Thank you, Sophie.
You have our gratitude. Anyway, what are you planning to do?
Well, you see, I'm going to be turning Plakta into a doll.
Plakta. Oh, you mean that book.
That sounds wonderful. I didn't think we'd get to see something that amazing.
Yeah, I agree. Anyway, we'll just be quietly watching.
Okay, then I guess we should get started. I'll start now, Plakta.
Yes, please do so, Sophie.
Okay. Oh, Compass of Hades, guide Plakta's soul!
Refreshing being able to stand eye to eye with you.
I feel the same way. This is like a dream, having you able to stand next to me.
What are you talking about, Sophie? This isn't a dream. It's unmistakably reality. A reality more splendid than any other that you made possible. Now, let me thank you properly, Sophie. Thank you for giving me a body again. Thank you for working so hard for my sake.
Plakta! I'm glad! I'm so glad!
Sophie, there's nothing to cry about. This is a happy occasion.
Looks like it's all done. Sophie started crying all of a sudden, though. That was more surprising for me.
Hey, Oscar, you shouldn't say things like that. She worked really hard. Let her cry a little.
We got to see something really great, Automina.
Yes, I'm quite impressed, Mechlet.
But I'm really glad it worked. To be honest, I was a little scared. The doll parts were all made by others. They're all really skilled, so I didn't think there would be a problem there. But I was the one who made the Compass of Hades. I was worried about that not working. If I failed and you disappeared, Plakta, I'd be all alone in the Atelier again.
I wasn't even slightly worried. I believed in you, Sophie.
Plakta. Yeah, thanks. Oh, right! We should go show you off to all the people who helped us.
No. I said before that such spectacles were unnecessary.
Don't worry about it. Let's go!
Hey, those
Those two have completely forgotten about us.
Yes, but they both seem very happy.
We were thinking about leaving soon, but I don't know about leaving without telling our host.
Yeah, that's right. I guess we have no choice. We'll just stay and have tea until they get back.
That sounds good. I'll go prepare the tea. You're late. How long were you going to make us wait?
Huh? Monica? And everyone?
We were waiting for you. You ran off all of a sudden, and we couldn't just leave without telling you.
I ate way too many snacks. Ugh, my stomach hurts.
I didn't think our tea time would end up being this long.
Oh? I had fun. I don't mind.
Sorry! I ended up talking too much.
This isn't your fault, Sophie. It's been a long time since I had a proper conversation, so I got carried away.
It's fine. Anyway, we'll be going home now.
Oh, okay. Thanks for coming over today. Also, again, I'm really sorry.
No worries. Just be sure to help out at the store again.
Sophie, we really got to witness something splendid today. See you.
Farewell, Sophie.
Automina.
Yes, Mechlet.
Our wish will soon be fulfilled.